The motive is to inspire you to achieve your dreams in life. I'm just going to take you on a little journey on how to achieve your dreams from a startup to a multi-dollar industry. And what am I going to start with? I'm going to start with your purpose in life. Because if you don't have purpose, then there's nothing that you can achieve. You will run helter-skelter. If A tells you this is good, you go for it. If B tells you this is good, you go for it. But if you have got purpose in life, then let me tell you this. You will focus on that purpose and you will be able to achieve your dreams in life. The question is, what is your purpose in life? This is a very difficult question because everybody can take it from any angle. Somebody can say, my job is my purpose. Somebody can say, my business is my purpose. You know, there's so much definition to your purpose in life. But to me, your purpose in life is that thing that you love doing, that thing that you are passionate about, that thing that you yearn for, you do it without struggle, that thing that is so easy to do, like what I'm doing now. I like inspiring people. It's my passion. It doesn't even look like a job because that is what I love doing. But there is one thing that I always disprove in terms of people. Some people will tell you, listen, my passion is my job. Anything that have an end to me is not a passion. Now, if you say your passion is your job, it means when you are 60 and you retire, your purpose ends, your purpose goes beyond your pension age. So anything that you love doing, that you are passionate about. I was speaking to somebody and he has a business. And he said he loves doing it so much. The point is, if you have a business, your purpose is unlimited. The point is, at the age of 60, you don't retire, you continue doing your business. So your purpose in life is that thing that you love doing, that thing that you are passionate about, that thing that you yearn for, that thing that you do that you don't struggle. How can you identify that purpose? There are two ways. One is yourself. Second is the people around you. You yourself know what you love doing. You know what you are passionate about. I met a lady who loves children so much to the extent that she has built a daycare center out of it. Listen, your purpose is that thing you love. So you know it better than we do. You need to identify it. You are the first point of contact to identify your purpose in life. The second is the people surrounding you, your families, friends, and your contact list. Sometimes they tell you, man, you are good in this. You are good in that. You are good in this. But sometimes we don't take notice of it because we haven't really tuned our mind to identify our purpose. Let me tell you, anything that somebody consistently tells you that you are good in it, you need to take a second look at it. I met a Nigerian in a restaurant in London, and this guy was so funny. I told him, listen, you are better than some of the comedians in Nigeria, but why are you taking it to the next level? He said, that's what a lot of people tells me. I said, that is your purpose. If a lot of people are telling you, you need to take a step further to use it as a dream. So your purpose in life is the people around you Whatever they tell you, it should send you a signal that, listen, I have to look into this and develop it. A lot of people told me I'm good in inspiring people. And I personally yearn for it. So I identified it myself, and people around me substantiated it. So you need to identify it first, and secondly, the people around you will also help you to identify it. I'm going to continue this series. Stay blessed, and I will come back very soon. Welcome back. We just talked about your purpose in life, and it means that if you have purpose, you can translate that purpose into an idea. The point is, a lot of us have got loads and loads and loads of ideas. And the question is, what makes your idea so unique? You see, ideas to me are like seeds. If you are holding a seed in your hands, I relate you to the idea that you have. Now, what idea do you have? You see, a seed can house the biggest tree on earth. But when I give you a seed, there's nothing to write about. There's nothing good about the seed. The seed in your hands is worth nothing. But that seed that is in your hands can house the biggest tree on earth. In the same way, the idea that you have can really be the biggest multinational company on earth, for example, or it can be the biggest business on earth. So why have you hung on to your idea for far too long, not taking a step to make it work? Your idea that you have is a multi-dollar industry in your hands. Now the point is, some people have developed their ideas to be successful. You see, in life, there are three types of dreamers. There are people who dream, and their dream forever stays in their mind. You speak to them today, they say, yes, I've got this business I want to do. I have got this idea that I really want to put it across. Now, in 5 years, if you meet them, they are talking about, they are still at the idea stage. These are the first category of dreamers. They dream, and their dream forever stays in their mind. They are passionate about it, they love talking about it, but they never take a step. Which one is the second category of dreamers? The second category of dreamers are those that dream, take action, but along the way they give up. I know many of us in 2015, our aim is really to translate our ideas, our goals into fruition for us to achieve it at the end of the year. But the question is, in this journey of 12 months, there are going to be uncountable challenges. And for some of us, we just give up along the way. So if you have given up on your dream, something you are passionate about, something you want to achieve in life, something you yearn for, I'm here to encourage you today, go back to the drawing board, pick up the pieces and start all over again. Because the second category of dreamers, what they do is that they start A, along the line they have a challenge, then they give up. Then they go and start B, along the line they face challenges and they give up. So by the end of the year, their hands are full of too many unfulfilled tasks. The point is, concentrate on what you are passionate about. I'm so lucky I have seen what I love doing. I don't know about you. You need to go back to the drawing board. As I said earlier on, that try to identify what you can do to the best of your ability. And that is the first step to success. Because with that, it doesn't become a job, but it becomes a passion. It becomes something you love doing. Then we have got the third category of people. They are the people that we always, you know, talk about. They are the people that we always praise. They are the people that start a dream,
They take action. They persist and persevere until they are able to achieve their dreams. They are our heroes in society. The question is, they were successful because they never gave up. So you, the first and second category, if you want to be in the third category, this is the catchphrase. Never give up on your dreams. My father always told me something. He says, Oscar, no matter the situation, there is always a way around it. And let me tell you, no matter the challenges that you are facing, there is always a way around it. You can achieve it. You can really move to the next level of your life. The point is, I will come and talk about mentorship and how to move on and a whole lot. But the point is, you are bigger than what you are doing. You can always take that next step and move on to your destination of success. Let me tell you, I want to encourage you that this year, don't give up. The sky is no more the limit, but it's a stepping stone for greater things to happen in your life this year. Stay blessed, and I'll come back again.